So let us see how to create this DFA for LALR and CLR parsers. So here I've written how to find the closure, and according to this closure we'll also find how we'll also draw the DFA. And assuming that the grammar is S derives AA and A derives AA slash B. So I'm trying to keep the grammar standardized or common for all the parsers, so that we'll be able to understand the difference between these parsers and their parsing, difference between their parsing algorithms. That means how do they parse and what is the difference between creating the DFA. Okay, so initially we are going to create the I naught, that is the initial state, and for that we have to make the grammar as augmented grammar, that becomes S dash derives S derives AA, A derives AA slash B. Now we'll start by finding the closure of the start state. So initial state is S dash, so we have to write S dash derives S dot S comma dollar. Now you can clearly see this is S is a start state, and the look ahead symbol for the start state is always dollar. So those of you who are still wondering how to find the look ahead symbol, just make it a thumb rule that if you start with the start state, then the look ahead symbol for the start state is always dollar. Now if you want to find the look ahead symbol of the next state, now for example, because this dot is before this S, so we have to write all the productions of S with dot in the beginning, so you get S derives dot AA. Right, but here we have to find the look ahead symbol. How do you find the look ahead symbol? You have to see after this S, is there any variable here? And you can clearly see there are no variables here. Therefore, because there are no variables here, so this exact same look ahead symbol will be copied here. So the look ahead symbol for this state will also be dollar. Now, because there's a dot before this A, so I have to write all the productions of A with dot in the beginning. So we get A derives dot AA slash dot B. But now we have to give the look ahead symbol. How do you give the look ahead symbol? After this A, we have this variable A. So whatever the first of this variable A, that will become the look ahead symbol here. The first of this variable A is A slash B, that you can see here. Again, here also it is A slash B. Now this is going to give us the first state. So this is the first state for our DFA. Now from this DFA, we are going to shift. Right, so we are going to write the go to symbols. For the first go to symbol is for this variable S, so we are going to make go to S, that becomes S dash derives S dot, and the same look ahead symbol dollar will come here. Okay, now we have to write the look ahead symbol, or we have to shift this A, that is the second one. So I have to write go to capital A. So we are going to get a new state here. Now in this new state, this is go to capital A. That means I'm going to shift this dot after this capital A in this production. So we get S derives A dot A comma dollar. Now this dollar is copied because of this one, the previous production, it is copied, but we have to find the look ahead symbol for the other states. Okay. And because there's a dot before this variable A, so I have to write all the productions of A with dot in the beginning. So I get A derives dot AA slash dot B. But you can clearly see after this A, we don't have anything here. That is why the same look ahead symbol will be copied here. So here we get dollar and here we get dollar. So this is the next state. Again, in the previous case, again from here, I can shift with small a. So I can get a new state here, right? So that is for small a, and that state is A derives A dot A, and the same look ahead symbol will be copied here, that is A slash B. Now you can see after this A, there is no variables, right? So therefore this look ahead symbol will be copied for other variables also. And secondly, because there's a dot before this A, so I have to write A derives dot AA slash dot B, and the same look ahead symbol will be copied here, that is A slash B and A slash B. Got it? Now you have to write for the next production, that is B. So you get this new state, which is where you shifted B, that is go to B. So you get A derives B dot comma A slash B. That is the same look ahead symbol will be copied here. Okay. Right. So this is also a final item. Now for this state you can shift A and you can get a new state. Okay, you can shift capital A, so you get S derives AA dot comma dollar. See, whenever you are creating a new state, now the same look at symbol, the previous state will be copied here, but for the upcoming productions here we have to find the next look at symbol. For example, here we have if we shift by small a, okay, this is small a, if we shift by small a, so we get A derives small a dot A comma, because here the look at symbol is dollar, therefore the look at symbol will be dollar here. Secondly, now because there's a dot is before a variable, that is why I have to write all the productions of this variable with dot in the beginning. So we get A derives dot AA slash dot B. And thirdly, after this variable A in the original production, there is no production, therefore the same look at symbol will be copied here. So we get dollar and we get dollar. Okay. Now I can also shift with the variable B, with the variable B, and I can get a new state here. So we have A derives B dot, and second we have dollar, right? Now for this particular next state, now I can shift with capital A here so that I can get a new state. If I shift by capital A, so that state will look something like this: A derives AA dot, and the look at symbol is same, that is A slash B, and right. And if I shift by B here, then I can go to this state only if I shift by B. And if I shift by small a, then I'm getting the exact same state. So if I'm shifting by small a, then I'm getting the exact same state. Okay, further, if you shift here, if you shift in this state, if you shift by A, capital A, then you'll go to a new state, right? So if you shift by capital A, then you go to a new state, that is A derives AA dot comma dollar. See, there are two states here. Here, just for this fact, here we have a state and here we have a state. In these two states, the items are same, but the look at symbols are different. That is why I'm showing them as different states. Okay. Now, here I can also shift with small a. If I shift by small a, then I'm going to get the exact same state. So that is why I'm going to create a loop here. This is the exact same state. So that is why I'm going to create a loop here. Okay. Now, I can also shift by small b. If I shift by small b, then I'm getting a new state. And that new state is actually equivalent to this state. So that is why I'm going to mark it like this. Okay. So you can see how many states are there. There are so many states. How many states are there? Let us number them. So the first state is represented by I naught. This one is representing I1. This one is representing I2. This one is representing I3. This one is representing I4. This is representing I5. This is representing I6. This is representing I7. This is representing I8. And this is representing I9. So there are nine states here. So this is how you can create this diagram for LLR parsers. So let us do one thing, let us take one more example of this, and then I'll show you how to create LLR parsing table and how to do LLR parsing. See, LLR parsing is very similar to LR parser. The same algorithm will work for parsing, so that is why I'm not specifically covering their algorithm for parsing. I'm going to cover after LLR how to convert that LLR table to a CLR table. Okay, parsing table. So let us look at in the next video.